Hey everyone, what's up? My name is Brad Hussey. This is the Art, Business, and Craft of Web Design. And today kicks off the first video of a brand new free web design course that I'm making just for you. And I'm calling it, let's call it the Building Blocks of Web Design. And it's going to be how to teach you to be a remarkable principles-based web designer, whether you are already a web designer or you're just totally starting from scratch. So let's just kick into that right now. All right, everybody, what's up? I was just dancing to my theme song there. Love it. Okay, so first video in this course. I don't know how many videos there's going to be. It's just going to be a weekly thing, and I'm thinking, I don't know, if I'm going off of my notes here. I got about 12 to 14 videos planned out, but here's the deal. This is going to evolve as I get feedback from you. It's going to be weekly. I'm going to publish a new free lesson each week right here on YouTube. And it's going to be all about the principles and the basics of web design. So let me just flip my screen here for you so you can see what I'm talking about. So the building blocks of remarkable web design. What are you going to learn? Well, we're going to dig into some design principles. So that's layout, color, typography, hierarchy, and so on. And also web-based principles. So UX, that means user experience. UI is user interface. Wireframes, interaction, building sites. So the whole point of this with web design is that it's a hybrid between graphic design and web development. So it's kind of this taking the web and taking design and mashing them together. So design has been around for as long as people have been creating layouts and writing documents and organizing information and creating art. But then with the web and the internet, which is a relatively new invention in the terms in the broad span of human history, it's taking the design principles and putting it into the web. And then also it's created a whole set of new problems and things to explore, like interacting with things like hardware, like a mouse or keyboards or screens and other people in real time. So we take design principles and web principles and put them together. So we're going to be digging into that as well. And these are all principles. Okay. So it's not just about trends or about what is popular or the latest and greatest programming language or design tool. Those things will come and go, but the principles will always remain the same. And we're also going to dig into skills. So what actual skills do you need? What languages should you learn? What software should you learn? What techniques do you need to know when it comes to design or photo editing or using a specific tool to get a specific effect on your website? Things like, how do you put a form on your site? All these things are skills that you need to learn that are agnostic to the tool that you use. Also, software. In 2021, at the beginning here of 2021, we've got a lot of really cool tools at our fingertips. Things like Webflow, other no-code tools, like Squarespace. We've got lots of different website builders. We've got Adobe XD, Figma, Sketch, Photoshop, all of these things. There's a lot of tools as web designers at our fingertips, and I want to be able to show you, okay, what actually matters? What should you look for in a tool? What tools do I like? What tools do you like? What tools should we all like? What tools should we be using? And then also specifically at the end of the day, I want you to be a more valuable web designer so that you can ultimately make a living as a web designer. I mean, some of you may just want to do this as a hobby, and that's great, that's fine, but a lot of you probably want to know how to make a living doing this, which kind of brings me to my next slide. Who is this for? Well, this course is for 100% newbies, some people who've never built anything for the web or designed anything for the web at all. Maybe you've like opened up your Instagram and you've designed something with like Canva or something and you've tried to make a pretty post, or you have like a personal website. I don't know, just total newbies. I've designed this whole thing as if I was talking to someone who's like, all right, Brad, I have no idea how to design anything for the web. And the closest thing that I have to design is, I don't know, just like my little sketchbook or my drawings or whatever. So what I want to do here is I want to keep in mind the 100% newbies, but also I got a lot of developers out there who follow my stuff, who've been taking my courses, and a lot of really smart people, but they're really, really bad designers. And that's not meant to be a dig. It just is the truth that web developers and programmers are not good at designing stuff. They're good at building stuff, the technical stuff, the logical stuff, but the creativity and the art and the craft of design, well, not a thing for them, okay? So I want to actually help those developers who want to get better at design, communicating design, design language, but also if you just want to like not hire a designer and work with a designer, you just want to do it yourself, this is going to help you do that. Also, designers, same deal. Designers, you don't want to work with developers. I get it. We're kind of annoying. We don't think the same. We're not very creative. I want designers to be able to be their own design, you know, web designers. So you don't want to work with a web designer. You don't want to hire a developer. You want to do it yourself. This is going to help you as well. And then also experts, people who already know this stuff, but just want to judge me. I mean, revisit the principles. Let's just call it that. So with that, who's Brad Hussey? Who am I? If you don't know who I am, first and foremost, I'm a husband. I'm a father to two beautiful kids, soon to be three. And I'm a Canadian guy. That's about the core of this guy. I've been a web designer since 2009, making a living doing this stuff for a long time. I love building for the web. I love designing for the web. And I've been making a living based on the internet for a long time. I've been freelancing since 2012. No, actually, I've been freelancing since 2009 when I started designing, but I've been doing it full-time since 2012. And I've been teaching people web design. I've been building sites, working with clients. I've been teaching the business of web design, the art, business, craft of web design. My whole life, business life professionally has been about web design and building for the web and building a creative business online. I've got over 500,000 students. If you cumulatively add them up from Udemy and YouTube and my own courses, 500,000 people from nearly every single country in the world who have taken my web design courses, my freelancing courses, my business of web design courses. But really at the end of the day, I just really love sharing my skills, my God-given gifts and talents, my knowledge and my weird personality with people like you. And this allows me to do that. Now, the goal of this course is to enable you to be a better, more remarkable web designer who designs based on principles and not trends, and ultimately to empower you to make a living with web design. Like I said, some of you, you may just want to do this as a hobby. That's great. But a lot of you, let's say because of this whole pandemic, lost your jobs, got fired, furloughed, whatever other words they use nowadays to just fire people, and everything's been turned upside down. And that's a terrible thing. And it's forced people to find ways to be able to provide for themselves and their families. And I've been saying this for a long time, that web design and building your own business and carving your own path, there's no better time than now. And I've said that prior to the pandemic, but even now with the pandemic, I see it even more clearly. The writing's on the wall. Carving your own path is the way. You can make a living doing work that you enjoy, that people need from you, that really matters, that makes a difference in your little world. And you can actually make a living doing that. You don't need to be a famous blogger or YouTuber or any of that crap. You just need to be able to solve a problem for somebody who needs it and then amplify that to enough to make a living. And it's very, very possible. So I want to be able to share that with this. The whole point is my transition into making a living as an independent business owner, as a freelancer, as an entrepreneur, it's been because of web design. That's like my through line. Web design, building for the web, designing for the web, creating for the web, to sell my own products and services, to help other people sell their products and services. Web design's been the key through the whole thing. And there's more than enough work for web designers to go around. There's lots of creative ways to use web design to make a living, and I want to enable you to be a better web designer, to transition into the career of web design, and so that you can design based on principles and fundamentals so that you can make a living. Now, why principles and fundamentals and not trends? Because trends come and go. People's desires for things come and go. People have a short attention span. But principles always remain true because it's the truth. Okay, now, why does this matter? Why does this course matter? Why do I even care to make this? Because as I kind of ranted about just now, web design is a growing and in-demand skill in a massive industry. And career flexibility is kind of the key here. You get massive career flexibility. You can work for yourself. So as a web designer, you can work for yourself. You can freelance. You can work remotely. You can build your own business. All of these things, you can work for somebody else. You can work at an awesome agency. You can work with startups. I've had the privilege of working for an agency at the beginning of my career, of freelancing on the side and paying some bills with some extra income, of going full-time as a freelancer and then ultimately building a business and then from there growing and becoming more of an entrepreneur because of web design. So I think it's a great idea. And there's a lot of work to go around. There's a lot of problems that need to be solved. And I think that you can do it. And I want to help you do it. Okay? So, and the best part here is you don't need permission to start. You don't need to go and get a diploma or degree. You don't need to go off and ask somebody, can I do this? Can I be a web designer? Yes. Yes, you can. Just shut up and do it. Just start, okay? You don't need permission to start. You don't need permission to learn a new skill. You don't need permission to build your own business, to sharpen your sword, to hone your craft. You don't need permission to go get clients, okay? If you're looking for permission, then I'll give it to you right now. You are allowed to go and be a web designer and to make a living doing it. How do you do it? I'm gonna show you right now in these videos, and that's the point of this course. The whole point here is to teach you the building blocks of remarkable web design so that you can be better at this whole thing, transition into the career, be better as a current web designer, and to empower you to make a living as a web designer in whatever capacity it is that you want to do. Okay, so with that said, this is my new course for you, by me, to you, about you. I don't know what I'm saying anymore. I want to gift this to you because 2021, it's a new year, but things don't change unless you actually commit to doing something about it. So I'm going to commit to helping you each week here on my YouTube channel, The Art, Business, and Craft of Web Design, with this new course, The Building Blocks of Web Design. So with that said, I want you to, right now, if you're not already a subscriber, subscribe to the channel, press that button down there. But then also you got to press the notification bell, the ding, ding thing, hit the ding, ding, so that you can get a ring, ring when I post some videos on the thing. This is getting weird really fast. Okay. Comment, let me know what you think. Are you excited about this? What do you want to know when it comes to web design? What questions do you have? Your comments, your interactions, your engagements, I'm going to be paying close attention to that because that's going to help shape what's next in the course. I mean, I've got principles, layouts, typography, color theory, planning your website, organization, wireframe, UX, UI, other jargony things, designing your site, building the site, the tools, launching it, all these things. I got this in here in the docket, okay, on the paper. It's official. But what you want is going to help shape what's next so that I keep your attention. Okay. So I really want to make this an amazing course, the best 2021 course that there is on web design. I've got the ability to teach you and the desire to teach you. And if you're all in, I'm all in. So let's do this. Subscribe, hit the notification, let me know your comments, and I'll see you in the next video. Cheers.